Hey, what's up, you guys? Bloody Jacob here to bring you my weekly review.
Hey, what's up, you guys? Bloody Jacob here, meeting my icon, Catherine Isabel here.
Hey, what's up, you guys? Bloody Jacob here to bring you a pretty long time coming video, and that is discussing the, for now anyway, cancelled TV series Hannibal, which originally aired on NBC for 3 seasons. Before again, they canceled it because NBC is one of those very cancel-happy networks. They canceled another great show that I liked, Dracula, although that may have been for, you know, some behind-the-scenes reasons, still not really sure to this day. But Hannibal went 3 seasons, and, you know, it did dip in the ratings a bit. You know, it went from around 3-4 million viewers, kind of down to 1.5-2 million, to actually a little bit below a million by the 3rd season, which I am, you know, kind of taken back by, because at the same time, it's also by far NBC's most critically acclaimed drama, and it really deserved all the praise too. Because, of course, this is about a younger Hannibal Lecter, Dr. Hannibal Lecter, played by Mads Mikkelsen. Focus on the relationship between him and a FBI Special Investigator, Will Graham, played by Hugh Dancy. It says here, a forensic psychiatrist, Dr. Hannibal Lecter, destined to become Graham's most cunning enemy, and at the same time, the only person who could understand him. Then you also have Lawrence Fishburne as Jack Crawford, the main FBI investigator, sort of like leading these investigations into various crimes, and eventually developing an obsession with Hannibal himself. It's hard to cram some kind of review on all 3 seasons into one video. I meant to do them one at a time, and I honestly probably should have, but I just kept watching, and then I watched other things, so it kind of got a little bit mixed up. So I just figured I'd just do like a big dedicated video to Hannibal in general, because Hannibal, it was a great, great show, fantastic. I really liked it. It's very well done, and I'm with everyone else. I'm just hoping that the revival plans actually go through at some point. The creator, Brian Fuller, he's been trying to do it for years. It seems like he has more freedom to do so now, over the past year anyway, but we still haven't heard of anything for certain. Hopefully it lands somewhere eventually, though. The cast, you know, as recently as like a year or two ago, had said they were still interested whenever something was done about it. Again, just a phenomenal show. At the basics of it, the cast is just on point all the way through, performance-wise. There's not really a weak bone acting-wise in this show. Mads Mikkelsen is absolutely masterful as Hannibal Lecter. I know a lot of people still think of the original Silence of the Lambs film with Anthony Hopkins, which is fine, but really, there's no one else that could top Mads Mikkelsen's portrayal for me now. He's a very nuanced actor. He gives a very nuanced performance in this role, I think. Just the different little flickers, his delivery of dialogue, his presence, it just really, really comes through. And then you have... And, of course, the character of Hannibal is just very, very complicated and very interesting to watch. You can't help but, you know, keep your eyes open. He's brilliant, you know, what kind of person he is, or, you know, how you know what he does anyway, you know what his favorite meal is, or at least the basis of it before he whips it up into something extraordinary. But at the same time, you're very compelled by him, you know, just like many people on the show are. And at the same time, there are some things that he seems somewhat correct about in how he tries to talk to people, but eventually drives them into their own sort of insanity for his own amusement, because he just gets a kick out of seeing how things play out. And that is just always so well done throughout the show. And you have Hugh Dancy playing Will Graham, who really could carry a show on his own if it wasn't for the fact of he and Hannibal's dynamic being the biggest part of the show. That was always so well done, with their very strange bond and almost love for each other. I thought it was very well explored, at the same time very subtle and just built very organically throughout. And Lawrence Fishburne is very good in the show as well. And then you have, you also have Gina Torres as Lawrence Fishburne's wife in this. She's dealing with lung cancer. And you see him just sort of just growing just more and more tired over this, and going through that, and everything that ends up happening with Hannibal, and everything that is happening with Will. Just everything. There's so much to talk about. There's no way I can cover everything in this video. I'm not going to try to. Not going to let this video go on for too long. But I also have to mention Gillian Anderson, who plays Lecter's psychiatrist, basically. But they have a history together, which is explored more as the show goes on. Of course, Gillian Anderson, she's very known for The X-Files, and she is a great element on the show as well. Like, her and Hannibal's scenes are almost unlike anyone else's. Just the way they would talk to each other is very, very interesting. And then, of course, I also have to bring up Catherine Isabel as Margot Berger. If you guys have watched any of my videos, or especially horror movie videos, you guys know Catherine Isabel is personally my all-time favorite actress, and just the fact that she is on this show in a recurring role for the last couple seasons, I'm actually proud to say it. And she is very good on this as well. She had presence to her. I know some people seem to have been mixed on her and her brother Mason Berger's story in this. Well, I admit, Mason Berger, he wasn't always, like, I don't think he was the best, like, villain on the show besides the obvious Hannibal. But, seeing just such an interesting perspective from the Bergers, I thought was good. And he also, I gotta give credit to Caroline, I can't pronounce her last name, Avernus. As Alana Bloom. She's a professor of psychology, she's close to Will, she eventually develops a connection with Hannibal as well. I guess she's our normal character, kinda. But yeah, she's very good. Like I said, there's not a weak actor on the show, there's absolutely not. And the pacing for each season I thought was absolutely brilliant. The dialogue, it's some of the greatest dialogue I've ever seen or heard in a TV show or even a film. It's so well written. Again, the delivery is almost flawless. And cinematography-wise, it's absolutely visually pleasing, too. There's a lot of great shots. It adds a certain visual aesthetic to it, likes of which I haven't seen and really much else besides maybe Penny Dreadful. And maybe, again, that Dracula series I mentioned earlier. It reminds me of things like that. It's like a modern day, almost like a gothic drama sometimes, And I really enjoy that. But I would also argue that Hannibal excels maybe at all of that even more than the other two shows I mentioned. That's how good it is. Although, Penny Dreadful is one of my all-time favorites. And Dracula would have been as well if it had gone on for more than a season. But... it's hard to say what my favorite of the three seasons were. At first, part of me just really liked, I don't know if I want to say Simplicity of the first season. But when, Hannibal had pretty much everyone fooled, even Will thinking he kept losing time and having these mental blackouts, possibly being this killer. It was all very interesting to watch. then of course season two, and Will actually knows, you know, what kind of, what's kind of going on with the Flector. You know, made for a different dynamic, and there's just a lot more tension, more, you know, kind of interesting other killers and stuff like that. And, you know, I'm debating between season two and three being the best at this point, because season three, as great as the atmosphere is throughout the whole series, I think it had an even bigger emphasis on its atmosphere and just the feel of it all. Again, sort of like modern gothic drama, right? It was just palpable in the third season. And, you know, I will say the third season at first seemed to drag a little bit more than the other two. You know, because other than, you know, there's the absolutely brilliant season two finale, which I have to name specifically. So let me bring it up real quick so I don't miss something. But yeah, the season two finale, with Amano, honestly, if I made like a list of like the top 10 greatest TV episodes I've seen, the season two finale of Hannibal would probably be on it. It's just such a well put together, like, full circle thing. You know, just, again, the dialogue, it's hard to explain, just watch it, and it's absolutely incredible. But yeah, third season's a little bit uneven in terms of pacing, at least for the first few episodes. You know, kind of, for some people, it seems to have taken too much time in, you know, reconnecting with some of the characters after what had happened. I know some people are frustrated because the whole first episode of season three is about, you know, just about Hannibal. We don't see Will, you know, Jack, Lana, or the others. You know, which I kind of understand. But what it led to is absolutely, again, incredible. He also had Richard Armitage in this season as this guy going by the Tooth Fairy, which he was eventually frustrated by, and then, you know, wanting to be known as the Great Red Dragon. You know, he wasn't my favorite, you know, kind of threat on the show. I thought his stuff was a little bit stretched out for some reason. I don't know. Richard Armitage is a pretty good actor, and I've seen him in some other stuff, even Pilgrimage with John Bernthal. You know, I get the whole Red Dragon thing being built up as well. But, you know, with and, you know, I actually did find his bond with this blind woman that he meets, played by an actress in True Blood, actually, Tara. You know, I had only seen, a season of True Blood, you know, not nearly the same type of or quality of show. But she actually played her part pretty well, too. But I did find their bond actually somewhat interesting. You know, I did get a little bit invested in that. But I don't know, it sort of felt like the way some people criticize Dexter, you know, season 7 and 8, and like the whole brain surge and thing and that. It almost felt like that to me, but I will say I think at least on that end, this delivered more than that per the Dexter 8 season. You know, although Dexter is a whole other discussion, we don't want to get into that right now. But yeah, you know, so it, you know, I wasn't as into that as I thought it was going to be. But also, this Great Red Dragon thing with Richard Armitage's character was also very much a vehicle for, you know, Will and Hannibal's bond reconnecting and actually growing on an even more deeper and personal level than ever before. And in that way, I think it succeeded as well. You know, so me and Maestro had a role, you know, for an episode or two in the beginning of the season as well. You know, she played a pretty important role in The Strain, so I just wanted to mention her too. But yeah, I thought the season 3 finale, The Wrath of the Lamb, was really great as well. And how Hannibal and Will end up going against, you know, the dragon together, you know, in a pretty brutal, you know, fashion by the end of it. Again, just so well filmed, so well shot. And, you know, for some people, they actually have made peace with the way season 3 ends and being the end of the whole show, because they have Hannibal saying this is all I ever wanted for us, and, you know, doing that together, seeing Will kill and, you know, working together, and then, you know, Will sort of just, you know, throws both of them off, you know, the cliff into the water, and, you know, we'll see what happens. So some people kind of made peace with them dying together, because he could tell Hannibal sort of let Will throw him off. But, you know, it's frustrating because you know they're going to do more. So, you know, that's not actually it. And also, it's a, you know, still kind of a prequel story. So, you know, I'm in favor of more Hannibal, so please. But still, almost as good as the season 2 finale, but not quite. But overall, looking at the third season again, I think it's almost neck and neck between season 2 and 3. And I still think season 1 works infinitely well for its introduction. But yeah, there's just so much I could say about Hannibal. It's a brilliant show. I'd give the first season probably an A minus, an A. I'd give the second season just a straight up A. Almost leaning to an A plus, almost. And then about the same for season 3. Almost perfect show, honestly. And admittedly, there's certain ways the quality is. Certain elements and qualities to it, it's almost greater than most other shows I've ever seen, whether it's, you know, an all-time favorite or not, which it is. But there's just something completely undeniable and, you know, irresistible about Hannibal, Dr. Lecter. So, yeah, let me know what you guys think about Hannibal. You know, what are your hopes for a revival that you still have? What's your favorite season and why? I'd love to talk about more. There's so much to cover. But I definitely wanted to get my thoughts out there on how much I adore it, just like the rest of you. So, yeah, follow me on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, like, subscribe. I'll catch you guys next time. Peace.